Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the solution and discussion on gate question paper in Mechanical Engineering subject. And this is lecture number 30. We are continuing again with refrigeration. So in the earlier two lectures, we solved questions from refrigeration in the gate examination. And this lecture also we continue on refrigeration. We solve few more questions on refrigeration from the gate question paper. The first question is from 1988 question paper. A Freon 22 vapor compression system is operating at a condenser pressure of 9.6 bar and evaporator pressure of 2.19 bar. Its refrigeration capacity is 15 tons. The value of the enthalpy at the inlet and the outlet of the evaporator are 64.6 kilojoules per kilogram and 195.7 kilojoules per kilogram. The specific volume at the inlet of the reciprocating compressor is 0.08 meter cube per kilogram. The index of compression of the compressor is 1.13. Determine the power input in kilowatts and the coefficient of performance. And this is the refrigeration cycle, the standard vapor compression refrigeration cycle. And we are given P2. The evaporator pressure is 2.19 bar, P3, the condenser pressure is 9.6 bar, the refrigeration effect is 15 tons. H1, enthalpy at the inlet of the evaporator 64.6 kilojoules per kilogram. H2, enthalpy at the outlet of the evaporator 195.7 kilojoules per kilogram. Specific volume at the inlet of the compressor is 0.082 meter cube per kilogram and the N, index of compression is 1.13. So, the mass of the refrigerant we calculate from the given refrigeration effect. So, RE, refrigeration effect, equal mass into enthalpy change across the evaporator. So, 15 into 3.5. So, 15 tons, 1 ton equal to 3.5 kilojoules per second. So, 15 into 3.5 equal to M into 195.7 minus 64.6. So, solving the equation, the mass of the refrigerant M equal to 0.4 kilograms per second. And the work of compression for the compressor, so WC equal to N by N minus 1, P2 V2 into P3 by P2 to the power N minus 1 by N minus 1. So substituting numerical values, the compressor work equal to 1.13 divided by 1.13 minus 1 into 2.219 into 0.082 into 9.6 divided by 2.19 to the power 1.13 minus 1 divided by 1.13 minus 1 equal to 28.93 kilojoules per kilogram. So, the compressor power equal to, so the compressor work done into mass flow rate, so 0.4 into 28.93 equal to 11.572 kilowatts. So, the answer to the problem, 11.572 kilowatts. And the COP of the cycle, refrigeration effect divided by the work done, so 15 into 3.5 divided by 11.572 equal to 4.54. So, the compressor power is 11.572 kilowatts and COP equal to 4.54. The next question is from 1989 question paper. A reciprocating compressor in a vapor compression refrigeration system has a clearance ratio, clearance factor of 4% and the swept volume 26 liters per second. If the mass flow rate of the refrigerant is 0.46 kilograms per second and the specific volume of the vapor at the compressor suction and discharge are 37 liters per kilogram and 12 liters per kilogram respectively. Calculate the clearance volumetric efficiency and actual volumetric efficiency of the compressor. So, the given data, clearance ratio equal to 0.04, 4% equal to 0.04, swept volume is 26 liters per second, mass of the refrigerant is 0.46 kilograms per second, specific volume at the compressor suction V1 equal to 37 liters per second and specific volume at the compressor discharge V2 equal to 12 liters per second. Now, the volume flow rate of the refrigerant V1 equal to capital V1 equal to mass into specific volume small V1. So, 0.46 into 37 equal to 17.02 liters per second. So, the actual volumetric efficiency is actual volume of the refrigerant divided by the swept volume. So, 17.02 divided by 26 equal to 0.6546 is the actual volumetric efficiency, 65.46%. And for the compression process, so, P2 by P1 to the power 1 by N equal to V1 by V2. So, P2 V2 to the P1 V1 to the power n equal to P2 V2 to the power n. So rearranging the terms, P2 by P1 to the power 1 by n equal to V1 by V2. So V1 is the compressor inlet swept volume, V2 is the compressor outlet swept volume. So 37 divided by 12 equal to 3.083. So the clearance volumetric efficiency, so eta V equal to 1 plus C minus C into P2 by P1 to the power 1 by n. So substituting 1 plus 0.04 minus 0.04 into 3.083 equal to 91.67. So the clearance volumetric efficiency is 91.67% and the actual volumetric efficiency is 65.46%. The next question is from 1993 question paper. A refrigeration system of 15 tons capacity operates on standard simple vapor compression cycle using refrigerant 22 at an evaporative temperature of 5 degrees Celsius and condensing temperature of 50 degrees Celsius. Draw the pH diagram of the cycle, calculate the refrigerant mass flow rate and compressor intake volume flow rate if the compressor volumetric efficiency is 0.72. So use the refrigerant property given, data given in the table. So the data given, condenser temperature 50 degrees Celsius, evaporator temperature 5 degrees Celsius, the pressure, specific enthalpy and specific volume data are given. Now we have to calculate the refrigerant mass flow rate and compressor intake volume flow rate. Volume flow rate at the intake of the compressor. So this is the temperature entropy and pressure enthalpy diagram of the standard vapor compression cycle. So that you have to draw. Now we calculate given data, we write down the given data. So volumetric efficiency is 0.72, refrigeration effect equal to 15 tons. So 15 into 3.5 equal to 52.5 kilojoules per second. Evaporator temperature T1 equal to 5 degrees Celsius. Condenser temperature T3 equal to 50 degrees Celsius. Specific enthalpy at the evaporator inlet is H1 equal to HF4 equal to 263.3 kilojoules per kilogram. Specific enthalpy at the evaporator outlet H2 equal to 407.1 kilojoules per kilogram. Now the mass flow rate of the refrigerant from the refrigeration effect. So RE equal to mass M into H2 minus H1. So substituting RE equal to 52.5 equal to M into 407.1 minus 263.3. So calculating the mass flow rate of the refrigerant, M equal to 0.3653 kilograms per second. Now the volume flow rate of the refrigerant, volume flow rate equal to mass flow rate into specific volume of the refrigerant at compressor inlet. So volume flow rate equal to 0.3653 into 0.0404 equal to 0.014758 meter cube per second. The compressor intake volume flow rate or theoretical volume flow rate equal to actual volume flow rate divided by the volumetric efficiency. So actual volume flow rate is, you calculated here, 0.014758 divided by volumetric efficiency is 0.72. So the compressor intake volume flow rate is 0.0205 meter cube per second. So this is the answer to the problem. The next question is from 1994 question paper. A refrigeration compressor of 50 millimeter bore and 40 mm stroke operates at a speed of 1460 rpm between condensing and evaporating pressure limits of 1.219 megapascal and 0.151 megapascal. The clearance ratio is 5%. Ratio of specific heat of the refrigerant is 1.18, specific volume of the refrigerant at suction is 0.11 meter cube per kilogram. And the enthalpy change of the refrigerant in the evaporator is 93.7 kilojoules per kilogram. Calculate the refrigeration load the compressor can serve. So this is the given data of the problem. So diameter equal to 0.05 meter, stroke length equal to 0.04 meter, speed equal to 1460 rpm. Condenser pressure P3 equal to 12.19 bar. So this is the temperature entropy diagram. So condenser pressure P3 equal to 12.19 bar. Evaporator pressure P2 equal to 1.51 bar. So clearance ratio is 0.05. So 5% is given here. Specific heat ratio gamma equal to 1.18. And the specific volume of the refrigerant suction is 0.11 meter cube per kilogram. Enthalpy change in the evaporator is 93.7 kilojoules per kilogram. So these are all the data given. And here we have to calculate the refrigeration load the compressor can serve. So the volumetric efficiency of the refrigerator, I mean compressor, so volumetric efficiency from the clearance ratio, so 1 plus C minus C into P3 by P2, the pressure ratio of the compressor to the power 1 by N. So calculating 1 plus 0.05 minus 0.05 into 12.19 divided by 1.51 to the power 1 by 1.18 equal to 0.7565. So mass flow rate of the refrigerant, so mass into specific volume at the inlet of the compressor, that is equal to pi by 4 d square L n by 60 into volumetric efficiency. So mass into 0.11, it is given V2, specific volume at the inlet of the compressor is given as 0.11. So pi by 4 into diameter 0.05 square, L equal to 0.04, speed equal to 1460 divided by 60 into volumetric efficiency is 0.7565. So the mass of the, so calculating the mass flow rate of the refrigerant equal to 0.01314 kilograms per second. Then the refrigeration load or refrigeration effect equal to RE equal to mass into H2 minus H1, the enthalpy change across the evaporator. So 0.01314 into 93.7 equal to 1.231 kilojoules per second. So this is the answer, the refrigeration effect that can be produced by the refrigeration system. The next question is from 1995 question paper. A refrigeration cycle uses Freon 12 as the working fluid. The temperature of the refrigerant in the evaporator is minus 10 degrees Celsius. The condensing temperature is 40 degrees Celsius. The cooling load is 150 watts. And the volumetric efficiency of the compressor is 80%. The speed of the compressor is 720 rpm. Calculating the mass flow rate of the refrigerant and displacement volume of the compressor. So the data are given, the refrigeration property data are given for the fluid. So minus 10 evaporator temperature minus 10 degrees Celsius, condenser temperature 40 degrees Celsius, the specific enthalpy, specific volume data are given. Now the given data to the problem, refrigeration effect equal to 150 watts, volumetric efficiency is 80% 0.8, speed of the compressor N equal to 720 rpm, the enthalpy at the inlet of the evaporator H1 equal to 74.5 kilojoules per kilogram, enthalpy at the outlet of the evaporator H2 equal to 183 kilojoules per kilogram. The specific volume of the refrigerant at the inlet of the compressor V2 equal to 0.08 meter cube per kilogram. And this is your temperature entropy diagram for the given refrigeration problem, refrigeration cycle. So 2 is the inlet of the compressor, 1 is the inlet of the evaporator, 2 is the inlet outlet of the evaporator or inlet of the compressor. And the mass flow rate of the refrigerant, so we calculate from the refrigeration effect. So refrigeration effect equal to M into mass flow rate of the refrigerant into enthalpy change across the evaporator H2 minus H1. So 0.15, so this is 150 watts given the problem. So 0.15 kilowatts, so equal to mass into 183 minus 74.5. So calculating mass flow rate of the refrigerant equal to 1.3824 in 10 power minus 3 kilograms per second. And now we calculate the displacement volume of the compressor. So the volume of the refrigerant, mass into specific volume is the volume of the refrigerant, volume flow rate of the refrigerant, this is equal to stroke volume or the sept volume into N by 60 into volumetric efficiency. So substituting 1.3824 in 10 power minus 3 into 0.08 is the specific volume at the inlet of the compressor equal to sept volume or the displacement volume of the compressor Vs into 720 divided by 60 into 0.8. So calculating the sept volume or the displacement volume of the compressor is 1.152 in 10 power minus 5 meter cube. That is the answer, displacement volume of the compressor. The next question is from 1996 question paper. In a simple vapor compression cycle, the following are the properties of the refrigerant R12 at various points. Compressor inlet H1 equal to 183.2 kilojoules per kilogram, specific volume equal to 0.0767 meter cube per kilogram. Compressor discharge H2 equal to 222.6 kilojoules per kilogram and the specific volume is 0.0164 meter cube per kilogram. Condenser exit H3 equal to 84.9 kilojoules per kilogram and V3 equal to 0.00083 meter cube per kilogram. The piston displacement volume of the compressor is 1.5 liters per stroke and its volumetric efficiency is 80%. The speed of the compressor is 1600 rpm. find the power rating of the compressor and refrigeration effect in kilowatts. And the given data, so V as swept volume equal to 1.5 10 power minus 3 meter cube per stroke, N equal to 1600 RPM, and volumetric efficiency is 0.8. And this is the refrigeration cycle for the given problem. Temperature entropy diagram and pressure enthalpy diagram. The actual volume of the vapor, so VA equal to eta V volumetric efficiency into swept volume into N by 60. So 0.8 into 1.5 into 10 power minus 3 into 1600 by 60 equal to 0.032 meter cube per kilogram. This is the actual volume of the vapor, refrigerant vapor flowing. And mass of the vapor of the refrigerant, M equal to actual volume of the refrigerant divided by the specific volume at the inlet of the compressor. So 0.032 divided by 0.0767 equal to 0.417 kilograms per second. And the power rating of the compressor, P equal to M into H3 minus H2, which is 0.41 into 222.6 minus 183.2 equal to 16.43 kilowatts. And refrigeration effect equal to M into H2 minus H4, which is M into H2 minus H1, which is 0.417 into 183.2 minus 84.9 equal to 41 kilowatts. So the answer to the problem, power rating of the compressor is 16.43 kilowatts and the refrigeration effect in kilowatts equal to 41. The next question is from 1999 question paper, and ammonia, R717 ammonia vapor compression system operates on basic vapor compression refrigeration cycle. The evaporator and condenser pressure are 0.119 megapascal and 1.389 megapascal respectively. The mass flow rate of the refrigerant is 0.1 kilograms per second. The volumetric efficiency of the compressor is 84%. Determine the compressor displacement rate. If the COP of the cycle is 2, determine the power input to the compressor. Saturation properties are of ammonia. For the condenser temperature minus 30 degrees Celsius and the evaporator temperature 36 degrees Celsius. So the pressure is given 0.119 megapascal, 1.39 megapascal. So we are given specific enthalpy of the refrigerant and specific volume of the refrigerant for the two pressures, condenser and the evaporator pressures. So the given data, mass of the refrigerant M equal to 0.1 kilograms per second. Volumetric efficiency is 0.84, evaporator pressure is 1.19 bar, condenser pressure P3 equal to 13.89 bar, and this is the temperature entropy diagram of the vapor compression cycle. So, one is the inlet of the evaporator, two is the outlet of the evaporator or inlet of the compressor, and three is the outlet of the compressor. So, the specific enthalpy at the evaporator inlet, H1 equal to HF4 equal to 371.4 kilojoules per kilogram. And the specific enthalpy at evaporator outlet, H2 equal to 1423.6 kilojoules per kilogram. So, these are all the values taken from the table. The specific volume of the vapor at the compressor inlet, V2 equal to 0.9638 meter cube per second. Now, the compressor displacement rate, so this equal to the actual volume of the refrigerant equal to swept volume into the volumetric efficiency of the compressor. So, 0.1 into 0.9638 equal to swept volume, volume flow rate, compressor displacement rate into 0.84. So, calculating Vs equal to 0.11474 meter cube per second. So, that is the compressor displacement rate. And refrigeration effect RE equal to M into H2 minus H4, which is M into H2 minus H1. So, calculating 0.1 into 1423.6 minus 371.4 equal to 105.22 kilowatts. So, this is the refrigeration effect. So, the power input to the compressor. So, W equal to RE by COP. So, 105.22 divided by 2 equal to 52.61 kilojoules per second or kilowatts. The power input to the compressor. The next question is from 2000 question paper. In a 5 kilowatt cooling capacity refrigeration system operating on a simple vapor compression cycle, the refrigerant enters the evaporator at an enthalpy of 75 kilojoules per kilogram and leaves with an enthalpy of 183 kilojoules per kilogram. The enthalpy of the refrigerant after compression is 210 kilojoules per kilogram. Show the TS and pH diagram. Calculate the following. Power input to the compressor, rate of heat transfer in the condenser. And this is the refrigeration cycle for the simple vapor compression cycle. and this is the pressure enthalpy diagram. So you have to draw the temperature entropy and the pressure enthalpy diagram. Then we have to write down the given data to the problem. The refrigeration effect equal to 5 kilowatts. Specific enthalpy at evaporator inlet H1 equal to 75 kilojoules per kilogram. Specific enthalpy at evaporator outlet H2 equal to 183 kilojoules per kilogram. Specific enthalpy at the compressor outlet H3 equal to 210 kilojoules per kilogram. All these data are given in the problem. And the mass flow rate of the refrigerant from the refrigeration effect, RE equal to M into H2 minus H1. So, phi equal to M into 183 minus 75. So, solving this equation, we will get M equal to mass flow rate of the refrigerant equal to 0.0463 kilograms per second. The power rating of the compressor, W equal to M into H3 minus H2, which is 0.0463 into 210 minus 183 equal to 1.25 kilowatts. And the heat rejected in the condenser, so QR equal to M into H3 minus H4, which is M into, which is M into H3 minus H1 equal to 0.0463 into 210 minus 75 equal to 6.25 kilojoules per second. And we stop here. So these are all the books I have published in mechanical engineering subject. And I have a YouTube channel where I upload the video lectures on the solution for the gate question paper. Also the video lectures on the subject mentioned here. You can subscribe the channel, use the video lectures for your better learning and pass in the gate examination. So thank you for watching. And you please post your comments on the comments box of the YouTube video. So you subscribe the channel and you can write to my mail ID for further details in the subject. So we'll meet again with another video in the next video on the solution on the questions from the gate question paper.